Hey there, Angie. We are talking rats. We're talking roaches, mold. Those are just some of the issues that students here at Howard University are complaining about. Videos sent to Fox 5 shows water pouring out of pipes, expired air filters with mold and mildew.
Look at this. Like, are you serious?
And mushrooms growing on ceilings and walls. With tuition being nearly $50,000 a year, they say they're frustrated with how Howard University's administration has handled the situation. Many students we spoke to want to remain anonymous out of fear of getting expelled.
Example that Howard failed with their forms of gaslighting. You cannot give us a last-minute homecoming and think that it will take the attention away from students living in unlivable conditions. Students are homeless and are paying unreasonable amounts of rent because of housing issues. Enough is enough.
Hey, what is up, you guys? Don't mind how I'm looking. I am editing right now. I just wanted to put this part in real quick. Yeah, so people were saying all types of stuff, and I really just want our attention to be focused on where it should be focused on, because we don't realize it, but like we're like going against each other when the sole focus should be on admin and what they're doing. So it shouldn't, like, people, I feel personally, people have the right to attend their college experiences and have fun at their college experiences, and I also feel like they shouldn't have to sacrifice those things because Howard doesn't want to handle their business. I want people to understand that this is some people's first and some people's last homecoming, and also take into consideration where the world is at and how like a new strand of something can come out and all of this could just leave us, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not saying there's a right or wrong. I'm just asking you to take, or at least take the judgment out of it and understand where people are coming from. That's all I'm saying. And then also just remember that this isn't a student versus student thing. This is administration. I think that the problem is, and what like makes it really crazy and just terrible, is because how admin would record us while we're in the lines and while we're at these events and post these things while students are sleeping in tents and stuff, while students have dorms that they're paying for but are protesting and sleeping outside and stuff because, again, Howard doesn't want to handle their business. That's what needs to be spoken about, the fact that admin will still post this stuff acting like, you know, there's not students outside in tents and stuff just fighting for their lives, basically, you know what I'm saying? So I think that's where the focus needs to be on, not these students who are trying to make the best out of their situation. So yeah, let's just keep the focus on what it needs to be focused on and not trying to pin and make it seem like, oh, you're this terrible type of person, or you're a coon, and you're all types of stuff. Like, the same people who are in these lines for like like I was saying, like the people who are in those lines were the same people who are donating, the same people who are retweeting and liking and sharing and stuff like that. Like you can't, you know, these were the same people who are helping each other out. I feel that all the students are with each other. Nobody's just, well, I can't say that because some people are acting trifling. But for the most part, we're supporting each other. We're there for each other, despite if we went to homecoming or not. And yeah, and I'm not here to convince you to think people are right or wrong. Your opinion is your opinion. I don't really care. I just want you to put the judgment aside. You know what I'm saying? For a couple of seconds. That's all. But yeah.
That's how we feel. Hey, you know, all that power. Thank you. morning, y'all. It is 7:30 right now, like 7:34, almost 8. We're in the... Good morning, guys! yeah, we're in the line right now for Yard Fest. Supposedly, the city girl's supposed to be coming through. I'm
guessing that's why this line looking like this. This early in the damn morning.
If I don't get to 19 cars, so yeah.
So excited. We stopped at McDonald's this morning, and that's what we eating on. But yeah, we have 3 hours till they open the store. Pray for us, child.